So good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Trade Out Loud Futures Trading Room. My name is Anka Metcalf. Within these 3 days, we will be hosting the open house, everything futures. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, but I'm going to ask you a quick thing. While we're trading, especially in the power hour, no questions, but I will be open to answer any questions after we're done with trading. So for those of you that are new and do not know me, my name is Anka Metcalf, and I'm the CEO and founder of TradeOutLoud.com, which is a trading education company that is specialized in educating individuals how to day trade, swing trade, and actively invest in any market, whether it's the stock market, whether it's the futures market, crypto market, any kind of market options, whatever you guys are doing. We specialize in educating individuals how to become professional traders, how to become consistent traders, how to become successful traders. I have been a professional independent trader for more than 20 years. And prior to becoming a professional independent trader, I come with 10 plus years in investment banking. Also, I run two programs. I run a swing trading program for stocks, and I run the trading room every morning from 9 o'clock until about 11:30 and or until we're done. Sometimes we're done in like 15 minutes and we're done. And sometimes we have to stay until the trade closes, right? Because the trade has a mind of its own sometimes. All right. So also I do specialize in high velocity moves. What that means is that I'm stalking the price action and I am literally getting into the trade for maximum results. So that means that I'm not going to go in and out, in and out, in and out, and probably call 20 trades, but we're going to call one or two trades, maximum three trades and done. Typically, it's going to be one and done. So be very careful. So I'm going to ask you quickly right here, guys, would you rather go in and out of trade and make just a couple of ticks or make just a few points and then get out and then get back in and get back out and accumulate all of these commissions? Or would you rather wait for a really substantial trade, go in, make your money, and then done? Right? Okay, awesome. All right. So I specialize in these velocity trades. You guys are going to see that I mainly am going to look at the 5 minute charts because this is kind of like the sweet spot. It's not too fast as the 1 and the 2 minute, and it gives us plenty of time not only to react and put in our orders, position size, calculate our position size, but it also gives us enough time to analyze, and we're not making rash decisions. And it's not as far as 15 or 30 minute or 1 hour where we could definitely be stuck in trades for hours or even overnight. So I don't know about you guys, but I love instant gratification. Okay. So quick disclaimer here before we continue with everything. All information provided in here is for educational purpose only. It should not be construed as investment advice regarding the purchase or sale of any type of securities, whether it's options, futures, forex, or any instrument of any kind. I know you guys know that trading carries a lot of risk and may not be suitable for all traders and investors because you could lose money. So before deciding to trade, you should carefully consider your objectives, level of experience, and obviously your risk appetite. Individual performance depends upon each person's skills, and you're going to see that traders in the trading room, once I call a trade or I provide different options for different levels of comfort in your tradings. For example, for smaller accounts, you can definitely take profits around target one. But if we have like a surge of momentum, I'm going to tell you guys to stay in and then we will manage the trade all together. So I'm presenting different kind of options for every level trader. All right, so let's get started, everybody. First of all, just a few quick things that I need to clear out. For those of you that want to hear more about Trade Out Loud, who I am, what we do, track performance, everything else, you could find on our website. You could also find us on social media. Our handle is Trade Out Loud. But here are some rules before we actually start the day, because it's still very early and I don't really trade before 9:30. So no questions in the first hour. The first hour is the power hour where we focus on trading. I don't care about anything else, how the weather is, what's happening in the news, what's on CNBC, or what the chatter is anywhere else. I don't care. It's my time. I'm zooming in into my analysis because this is the time when I generate my income. We will allocate time at the end of each session within these 3 days for Q&As. And definitely we do this in our trading room as well every single day. Now, small account size can participate in trades and any kind of setups using micros. If you're here for the very first time, just watch it and watch the dynamics. Position sizing is key. We recommend traders to use 1 or 2% of their account size risk per trade, depending on your risk appetite, depending on your risk tolerance, and of course, depending on your account size. I personally use 1%. So what do I do and what do I typically do? I typically exit half at target one. And when you guys are going to see me call a trade, the trade is going to have an entry. The trade is going to have a stop. It's going to have a direction, whether long or short, and it's going to carry several targets. Now, these targets are inflection points. Now, when the price reaches these targets, the problem is that these targets may signal reversals or pullbacks. So if you're in the growing phase of your account, you want to take profits a little bit sooner, even if you're below 1R or even below 2Rs. If I signal that throughout my charts, we have power momentum, then I'm going to say it out loud on the mic, stay in the trade because the momentum is likely to continue. All right. At target two, when we hit, I typically peel off another quarter, and that is if we have very slow price action. And then the rest of the position, my last quarter of the position, I trail it. So what I do is I find technical inflection points on the chart where I can raise my stop so I can stay in the trade a little bit longer. All right. So if trading with one contract full or micro, traders will look to trail since no partial exits are possible. Also, sample of trade call, you guys can see it right here on the slides. For example, if we're going to be trading S&P, I'm going to write ESL. L represents long. If we're going to take it short, it's going to be S. The parameters are going to be, let's say, 4430 buy. The X means buy. So it's going to be 4431, for example, buy 4420, and that's going to represent the stop. So the first number represents the entry, the second number represents the stop, and then TGT represents targets, and those are targets that we see on technical charts, areas where the price action is likely to pull back. But like I said, if we're getting a surge of momentum, then we can, you know, pretty much continue higher. And if I signal that, I'm going to tell everybody here, hey, stay in. No need to take partial profits in here. Not unless you really want to. And bigger accounts can definitely scale out into targets if you feel necessary. So all the trades will be called live on the microphone. But before that, we discuss what our favorite trade is and what our favorite setup is and what is the relative strength or what is the relative weakness, depending on whether bullish or bearish. So once we have everything on the plate, then we call the trade out loud on the microphone. While the trade is out loud, called out loud on microphone, the trade, I will be typing in the trade just like you guys see it right here. So there's going to be no, you know, surprises. Everybody's going to say, oh, are you in the trade? Are you, you know, did you get in the trade? So everything is going to be really clean and transparent. All right. So please be on time. Don't be late. We will answer all questions we will answer all questions, but if you're in the room, if you're coming later, we're in the trade, and if you have a question, I don't know what question it is, it's like, oh, I missed the trade, what was the trade? We're definitely not going to address that. So if you find somebody in the room that can share that with you, and you know, that's perfect. Because if I'm in a trade, I won't be able to do that because I'm trading my own account and I'm monitoring the price action. So I think that's more important to make money, right? Okay, so what else can we expect? We're going to dive right in a couple of seconds into the pre-market game plan. So I'm going to do the pre-market game plan for the four indices, NASDAQ, Dow, S&P, and Russell. And we're going to take a look at gold and oil for opportunities as well. We're going to be analyzing the whole context. We're going to go over the news. We're going to be analyzing the impact of price action. We're going to check out some major earnings reports. By the way, we have Home Depot this morning. We're going to be identifying some high ads patterns. Then we're going to be waiting for a trade. Patience is key here. We have a setup. We have a trade. We don't have a setup. We're not going to have a trade. Then we're going to decide on the execution strategy. I'm going to tell you what my strategy I'm using. I'm going to tell you and show you on the technical chart where my entry is, where my stop is, and where the targets are and where they are. Then at the end, we're going to do a recap of the trade and we're going to do a recap of the session of the indices in case you guys are going to want to look at the market later on in the afternoon. We focus on momentum, continuation patterns, trend trading. We're also focusing on counter trend trading and of course, swing trading. In fact, we are in a swing trade in the Dow, still long. Oh my goodness, from last week. And we're up like a lot in it, like over 350 points in that one. So how trades are called, trades will be called again out loud on the mic. So there shouldn't be any questions about it. All the trades will be posted in the trading room with caps. You're going to see me in the trading room type in the questions with caps. If it's not a momentum trade, there will be no time to post. So if there's a very strong surge of momentum in the market, I'm not going to post it in the room because I need to take the trade as well. So I'm going to be on the mic repeating it like five times. Okay. All right. We only use limit orders. We don't jump in trades. Okay. We only use limit orders. Okay. Sample of the trade. You guys have it right there. Now for today, we had Home Depot. We know that Home Depot is influencing and impacting the Dow. We've only noticed relative strength in the Dow from yesterday. None of the other stocks are going to impact any kind of index. Okay. So for today, we had Home Depot before the market. This is what's going to impact more of the Dow. So if you're seeing, for example, UNH, you're seeing Boeing, you're seeing financials like Goldman Sachs, Bank of America, AXP that are starting to move higher. And of course, Home Depot, Procter & Gamble, and some other big power play like Microsoft, for example, in the Dow, then the Dow is going to carry relative strength. So we're going to be focusing on that. Now, this morning, you guys see the market is higher. So this is super cool. We just had our PPI numbers. Just a quick recap. Whenever we had a PPI numbers a few times ago, we had the big surge in the market and we have the breakdown. So the price action came right back down to where it was before. So careful on that. We're going to pay definitely a lot of attention to that as well. Now, what else we have on the calendar for today? At 9:30, exactly when we open in about 15 minutes from now, or 10 minutes from now, we're going to have FOMC member Barr that is going to speak. We have business inventories at 10 o'clock. So 10 o'clock is a big inflection point into the market. And this is Tuesday. Got carried away. Okay. So here we go. We got the core CPI. And at 10 o'clock, we have Barr that is speaking. And then we have another member that's going to be speaking at 12:45. That's Long Con. We're done by then. All right, so we're going to dive into the pre-market game plan, everybody. And I'm going to shut off my, here we go. I'm going to move the screen. All right here. And what we're going to be doing, I'm going to shut off the, so you guys can see the charts and not my face. Okay. All right. So here we are right now. All right. Let me just get everything in here. We have 10 minutes into the actual open, your trading session open. This is what I trade. So first glance into the overall market, we have the Dow. You can see all the charts are on the 5 minute right here. So here's the Dow, 363 points up, over 1% up. We have the S&P, which is 60 points up, 1.36% up. We have NASDAQ, which is 267% up. We have it, points up 1.73%. So what do we notice from here is that we have relative strength in what? In NASDAQ so far. So NASDAQ a lot stronger than the S&P and a lot stronger for YM. And by the way, if you guys are swing trading, OMG, the stocks are literally set to rip because they're going to have some pretty impressive gap ups today. And then we have Russell, impressive 61 points up. Is this a typo right here? 3.58%? Wow. Is this a typo, guy? Like, oh my gosh, I got to pull up the chart. Oh my God, it's crazy. All right. Oh my God, this can't be. All right. Anyways, and we have oil. Remember, we were talking about oil at 78 bullish. Yeah, toss us. Hey, Daniel, if it's on the internet, it must be true. All right. So here is oil up over 1%. I told you guys it's bullish over $78. We had one trade yesterday. We chickened out of it. And then, you know, kind of like we're seeing right now, CL over 79. So it's up $1.20 from our key level yesterday. I don't know if some of you guys, I know you guys are in, but I didn't take that trade. All right, so here we have gold. Gold is up again, $14, almost 1% to the upside. And now we're going to dive into our game planning for the day. I'm going to take you to my technical charts to see where we're at and what can we do for today's session, okay? So here's the analysis grade. We're going to start with the Dow. Okay, so we're going to put this on the 1 hour right here. So the overnight trading session was very, very flat. Notice the slingshot effect. So when the numbers came out, this is the 1 hour. So when the news announcement came out, when the numbers came out, you could see here that we had a little bit of a slingshot effect, erasing these lows right here into the 360, punching a little bit lower, creating a 334 low in this case. Now, we have been talking about this inflection level for a very long time. In fact, we have been talking about this since the beginning of November as a possible blast off and continuation higher. And we said that we do have continuation to 35,000 and 35,300. We also noticed last week that we had an incredible move onto the monthly and that we have triggered a 1-2-3 rotation. And so therefore, we're on our way to trajectory and not only into the 35,000, but guys, into the 36,000. So this is impressive right here. And again, this is going to 36,000 is going to be like the critical level that if we get that is gonna have the ability to pull the price up. And also if it breaks above 36,000, it's literally gonna start exploding. And we may see a new high into the end of the year because we have 36,832 and we may see a brand new high. We're into a continuation pattern onto the weekly. So any kind of strategy is going to be bullish, at least in the first hour into our power hour. At this point in time, we had a strong momentum to the upside. We have the CPI numbers and we have the price action that is literally basing at this moment in time. And we have the S&P. So I really like the Dow. The S&P as well, very strong. It has eliminated the first resistance area at 4430 that we have been talking about forever. All last week, we finally made it higher. We crossed above the inflection point of 4430, which was created minor resistance from the prior pivot low from the beginning of September. And we do have room for higher, guys. 4,500 and 4,550 is going to be the next target into the S&P. And that is the room to run target. It doesn't mean that it's going to do it today. It may do it today. It may do it in 2 days, may do it in 3 days, may do it in 3 weeks. So that is the ultimate target that we see technically for the S&P. Then we have NASDAQ. NASDAQ, again, super strong today. It's literally amazingly strong. It's almost trading, as you can see from the monthly, as you can see from the weekly, is almost trading into these prior highs of 16,000. Yesterday and also last week, we've been talking about the 16,000 target. Well, here we are. We're getting very, very close to that. And as you can see here, by this blast, by the numbers this morning, we blasted above this resistance high of 15,728. And we are in motion for higher. So our objective for today, for this week, is going to be 16,000. And we're going to talk more about tomorrow about targets beyond 16,000 that can actually challenge these prior highs all the way. This is the this is by the way the high from November. You guys can see it. This is from November of last year, and that is the 16,000. And look how bullish November was last year, right? Seasonality shows us that indices are very bullish into November. Okay. All right. So here we go. 16,700 is the all-time high. Then we have the RTY, which wowzers. I mean, are you kidding me? Like, wow. Careful here because we have a weekly rotation, amazing weekly rotation that is going on right now. And we just punched in above last week's high, which is 72 and a half. So that means that it's on its way higher. And the target is for another, wow, 40 points almost higher. So the target is 1820 to 1825. We're going to have 1800, obviously, because it's a key psychological level. Then we have the 1820 to 1825. Then we have the 1830 to 1835 target. Then we have oil. We're about 4 minutes into the open, and I want to shift the screen to the other chart. So we watch a little bit the price action as we're heading into the open, because we have some pretty cool bases that we could take advantage of. And throughout all the indices. Now, remember that trades right off the open are really, really risky, and you could get a first stop out. So just wanted to put it out there. All right, so what do we have? Oil is right into resistance. If it manages to digest the $79, it's going to start moving higher to actually $80, almost $80. So 79 to 80, any kind of base, multi-frame base, 5 minute to 15 minute or shallow pullbacks in oil is going to be viable with the target of $80. And it's going to have, if it crosses above $80, it's going to go to $81 and $81.50. So these are the three targets for oil, bullish momentum within these last four trading days. And then we have GC, we have gold that is starting to pop up off of the 50 simple moving average off of the weekly. We had a daily rotation that is in play right now with the CPI numbers that trigger over 1950. This is the first resistance that we're encountering into the 65 to 70. If over 70, we have another 10 points higher into the 80. So watch momentum on smaller timeframes. All right, so we're going to go back into our analysis screen because we have about 2 minutes left, and I want to mention the fact that we have these bases that are here that are incredibly bullish in all the indices. The strategy is going to be a base breakout. We have the highest point in the Dow at 779. So that means that anything that trades above 80, 81, 82, 83 are acceptable entries with the first intraday target of 850 to 860. Same with the S&P on the 5 minute. We do have support. And by the way, the stops are going to be 700. Allow some room for fluctuation and make sure you position size. All right. So here we have it. This is the first. Here it is, 83. Then we have the 4490. Remember, this is poised to pop a little bit harder because Home Depot had earnings. Let me just take a quick look on my side at Home Depot. Home Depot is higher, is screaming higher, is trading right now $299.50. So yeah, that's the reason why the Dow is accelerating just ahead of the open. Then we have the S&P, which if it trades over $91, 91, 92 acceptable entries. The stop is going to be the 10 EMA, 44.79 has room to run. First target psychological level of 4,500, and then it has room for 20. Then we have NASDAQ. Again, the support is still the 10 EMA support, and stops are around the 10 EMA area. The pop-up area for NASDAQ is going to be 40 over 40, 41, 42 acceptable entries. And it has transitioned higher all the way to the 850, 880, 900, 920. And then we have Russell, which is literally like, wow, higher and 57 points. I got to do that with the calculator, like I'm telling you. Yeah, it's true. Wow. Yeah, I could see it. All right, so let's see the reaction off of the 10 EMA, and let's see the open surge from the when they opened the gates right now. Right now, guys, the market is open right now. Okay, so now we're gonna focus and see what trades we have. Oh my gosh, John, thank you so much, guys. Please read what John has just posted. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you so much, Jill, for the updates on the CPI numbers. Thank you, Doji Man. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Christian, seems like unreal, right? It's crazy. 3.54%. Like, are you kidding me? All right. All right. So, okay, guys, don't forget when you type in the chat room, if you want everybody to see your question, please click on everyone. There's the a little tab here, like a little blue. I think you guys have it blue. Is it the blue button on your side? Because I have no idea. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So it's a blue button. Just select everyone, because you have the option to select host and panelists or everyone. Just select everyone from there. All right. So why am I strong? First, I don't know whether we should get in on the first 2 minutes here. First 2 minutes, 2 or 5 minutes. We're going to do 2 or 5 minute high low. So that means we're going to be entering above the close of the 5 minute and place a stop below the low of the 5 minute. What I am looking at here, the danger zone and the Dow. So keep this level in mind, 725. If the price is going to go below 725, the price is going to start pulling back fast. Okay. So we have some danger zones here. Let's see. I could share it. No, I'm not. I'm not going to share it. You guys look at your 1 hour charts. We have dojis. Your 30 minute charts. We have dojis on the 30 minute charts, which provide us a key level for today. All right. So let's see. I kind of like the Dow here again. I think it's too early to get it at 9:32. This is a very aggressive strategy. You could take it at 9:32, but I'm going to wait for first 5 minutes. YM and S&P rushing higher. NASDAQ, here's what I'm looking at, guys, the 30 minute. Okay, you guys see these dojis? This could be a pause and a continuation higher, or this could be a pause signaling a pause and a pullback, and it does have a lot of room to pull back. So that's the danger zone right there. Okay, and same with S&P. Look at your 30 minute charts. You guys see it right here. We have a little sandwich. So that means that the bulls are really forcing their way higher. But we want to know, are they, is this like a false signal for higher? Or if they break below these lows, the price is really going to accelerate lower. Okay, so this is the 30 minute. Here we go, 30 minute here as well. See, this is the danger zone. It has entered 25, the danger zone, so this could pull back. So depending on the strength of this momentum that we had, the power surge here, we could have a shallow pullback or a big pullback. Okay, so let's see. So we have identified these ranges. We know that if they pop up above these highs, we're going to be extremely bullish. Same with Russell, by the way, 30 minute Russell. Danger zone is 1760. Below 1760 is going to start pulling back. So now we need to see if the indices are going to hold and which index is going to hold. And in the meantime, I'm going to update you guys on some stuff that I see here happening into the stock market. So for example, UNH is lower. So that means that it's creating a little bit more pressure for the Dow, the S&P, Goldman Sachs. Remember what I said, guys, keep an eye on financials. I posted on the X feed on Trade Out Loud. I said, pay attention to financials, especially Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan. They are higher. Financials are higher. Also, Walmart with a brand new high today, CRM with a brand new high today, Bank of America higher today. Boeing trying to erase the 200 SMA, so it's bullish. Microsoft with a brand new high today. We have Procter & Gamble with a brand new high today. So we have a lot of stocks that are higher today. We have Apple that popped up and now it's pulling back a little bit. So yes, we need to keep an eye on the stocks that are components, important components, strong components of the index. And now we're going to do a little bit of analysis on the NASDAQ stocks. All right. NASDAQ, Meta with a new leg up, brings me joy because I'm long Meta, I'm long Nvidia, I'm long Microsoft. Amazon with a brand new leg up, Tesla with a brand new leg up, and a gap up. Semiconductors are gapping up, makes me so happy because I'm in Micron. PayPal is up, Starbucks is breaking out. So a lot of strength in NASDAQ. I think we should put NASDAQ on top watch here. All right. So we are at 935. We just made a new baby high and now we're pulling back. The key level is actually 37 to 38 in NASDAQ. So the stop, the potential stop that I'm looking is going to be 780. We have a little bit of a divergence momentum. We're getting the Dow, which is a little bit pulling back here. And we're having a stronghold in NASDAQ, which is, by the way, Costco with a new little gap up and higher. Qualcomm up and higher. So we have more strength in NASDAQ stocks. Which is good, just good, good, good. We're going to do NASDAQ long. Let's do 40 by 80. Let's do 840 by 780. Please position size for that. So for example, if you want to risk $500 on this trade, just going to give you a quick idea. You guys know how to position size. All right, so, okay. All right, so if you're risking $500 on this trade, the difference between the entry and the stop is 60 points. On a 60-point stop, you cannot take it with a full-size contract, but you could take it with four micros if you're using $500, okay? If you're using $500. All right. So order filled. We're going to talk about targets. We have a complete sandwich on the 30-minute. We have 880, 900, 920 for targets. Yeah, gold is gone. Gold is gone. Right here was the entry. Gone. I saw it. I saw it too late. All right. Let's cut some of the noise here in Russell. Russell can be a trade over this high. So that means 774. I would do 1775. If you want to do RTY long. $17.75 And the stop goes just below this, so 1760. And you're looking for targets, ultimate target. $1,800. No. Lori, just crazy. Yeah. And I was thinking of a stall here and I was like, oh, okay, pullback. That's why I kind of shifted my attention to these indices. Just wow. Just wow. The igniting momentum was at 55. The igniting momentum was at 55. Yes, it's a call trade, Dave. 1775 by 1760, target, room to run to 1800. All right. I'm not really loving the momentum here. Kind of squeaky. Something is up here. These are 15-minute charts. We're cutting some of the noise from that base. All right. So NASDAQ. I said the target, the last target is going to be 920. 917, 900 to 917 is going to be really toppy. 900 to 917 is going to be really toppy. All right, let's start going. Indices have started to move a little bit. S&P, NASDAQ, let's go Russell with the rotation. Russell is challenging the prior high right now at 1774.4. All right, three ticks into the quarter in RTY. All right, here we go. For a minute there, my mouse froze. Can you believe that? That's the worst thing that can happen with a click, click. All right, no trigger in Russell yet. All right, we're trading over 850. I didn't post it as targeted, but 850 is an inflection point. And if over 850, and if it stays above 850, it's going to gain velocity towards 80. $57 for the high, Nancy. The reason why we're selecting wider stops is because this is a very volatile market and we don't want to get dinged out of trades. We want to stay in trades. That's why our performance is the way it is. Because we are not getting dinged out of trades as often. We get dinged out of trades and we are having stops, but most of our trades are winning trades. Over 75% win for, I think it was for last month or something like that. And average for the year, I could take a look and see. I can let you guys know a little bit later where we're out of trades. All right, order filled. You guys probably see it in RTY. Yeah, it's there for everyone to see. Okay, for this year, I had to peek. For this year, the win ratio, and I'm going to show it to you guys as well. For this year, the win ratio is for the whole entire year. So year to date, 64.75%. Average return, 0.23% per trade. And average for my position size, average return, 2,558. That's average. All right. RTY, we're almost into the 80s. Just one more ticket. Here we go. We're up 5 points. Danger zone is the stop zone. It's determined by patterns and strategies. And we teach 10 strategies in our course. Only 10 strategies. I mean, if you think about it, it's only 10 strategies. And basically, you're only using like two or three on a day-to-day basis. All right. I didn't want to carry more risk. However, Dow is working. S&P is working beautifully. The performance is on our website. If you go to tradeoutloud.com and go under the services tab, go to futures trading room, scroll all the way to the bottom, and you have the performance there. It's a tracker. And that represents only, like, that is just to have an idea of the performance because it shows one contract. I'm going to show you guys later my performance, but that is only for one contract. I position size, so I urge everybody to position size. That's how you're going to make money. Douglas, you're right on. I know you're in the swing. I'm still in the Dow, guys. Should we get 35,000 in it? I know. It's awesome. Okay, no trail stops yet. Nasdaq is back into the break-even zone. I'm telling you, not a lot of momentum here. Volume is winding down, and the volume has started to wind down a little bit since 9:36, and we're trading on a little bit lower volume than the first impulse that we had in the first 3 minutes. 6 minutes, I'm sorry, not 4 minutes. In the first 6 minutes. In the first 6 minutes, we have higher volume, and now the volume has gone down. Just regular volume. Are we getting some sandwiches here in the 5 minute? Let's take these babies to the 5 minute as well. See how volatile the 2 minute is? I'm not gonna keep it there. If you wanna have like a no sweat trading environment, you wanna keep it on a higher time frame. You don't wanna watch every single tick. And let's go back here on the five because we have a little bit of extension. We need to see if we are gonna tackle this 82.8. And if we take it, if we take this out, then yeah, we're heading towards that 1800. But definitely, we need to punch above and stay above 80 in order to do that. NASDAQ needs to take out 63 to 64, so definitely a little bit above this high in order to start printing higher. So far, it's in the power trend. I like the fact that we had this base here and we had the opportunity for this 10 EMA to catch up with price, and now it's kind of like holding the trend nicely. What's my take on profit in YM? Take profit in YM. Are you in? Let me know the price that you're in so I can help you better. Can you give me the price that you're in? 795. 795 would be the trail zone. 795. Here we go higher. We're just about to break above 63 in NASDAQ. New high in NASDAQ. Let's see if we get a new high in RTY. If you guys are in any other trades and if you need help with trailing, type it in the room. If you're in any other trades outside of the trades that I'm in, I can help you trail. So, for example, if you got in somewhere, I don't know, in the Dow, this 95 is your cutoff line, right? So you should trail this area. It's obvious that YM wants to go higher. Alex, if you scroll up, the targets are posted in the room. But I could tell you again, 880, 900, 917 to 920. Oh my God. gosh, Joe, you're in all three. Anytime, Alex. Oh my goodness. Awesome. We need to break above, like you heard Doug yesterday, 4,500 is the big area for S&P. We need to get above this 4,500. And once we get above this 4,500, we can launch higher. I don't know at this point if we should do the 5-minute bars. Like, I'm not doing it here. I'm not doing it in NASDAQ. I'm just keeping your, we don't have a good enough extension here. See, the Dow already launched. Dow already launched bigger. Nice, Lori, into 10 o'clock. Exactly, exactly. This is a nice bottoming tail hammer. This could be bullish above this high with a stop below the candle low. Nice and buy action here in the tail. By the way, yesterday, remember, we have such a boring day, but hey, market worked for us. Boring is good. Not pleasant. I don't like boring, but. Yeah, we still made profits. Exactly, Ray. Joe. Okay, so once again, we need the Russell over 80 and to stay above 80. And we need to see the YM extend to 880. Market taking a little bit of a pause here, right into 10 o'clock. Remember, 10 o'clock is a critical timing into the market. If we typically have a market that has blasted from 9:30 to 10 o'clock, usually at 10 o'clock, it's kind of like a danger zone because there's the risk of market pulling back. All right, we have a new high in NASDAQ. We have new high in S&P, new high in the Dow. Lori's call here, rocking and rolling. You should see a target back into the 75. Just a small grind in NASDAQ as well as Russell. It's like it's very, very timid. And I'm not surprised and I'm not shocked because when we came into the market was already 1.7% or something like that, 1.5%. Joe, you should move to Florida. Seriously. Yeah, right. Yep. All right, let's go, let's go, let's go. We have a tap into the 80s, back again in RTY. Let's keep our eyes on the prize. YM is heading into a little bit of resistance here, and it is 10 o'clock, and the market has decided to rally a little bit into 10 o'clock. So no pullbacks, but we're literally monitoring this situation very, very closely. Almost to 80. NASDAQ almost to 80, guys. Now, if you want, you could take some partial profit. Absolutely, Joe. Yeah, I know the feeling. Now, here's what most of the traders would do in this situation. They would short. They would short because the market was extended. The market was hyperextended. And they would short. The fact that we're moving right now higher, it's because these traders that are stubborn are stopping out of trades. Plus, the institutional power push is sweeping them away. So whenever you're seeing like some nonsense going on into the market and saying, oh my gosh, but why is the market like literally going higher when, you know, it's so toppy or it's into resistance or it's, you know, into a reversal time? Well, because a lot of traders are shorting it. And when the institution power push comes, all those triggers where they have their stops are flickering and they're pushing the market even higher. And so they're helping the institutional power push. All right. So we have target one that is achieved. If you want, you could take partial profits. If not, I'm seeing like the momentum is very, I don't know how to say this. I would say stable. The momentum is stable. It's on low volume and we're still trading on low volume, but it's stable. So 40 points already gained in NASDAQ, by the way, 40 points gained in NASDAQ. RTY is a resistance in RTY, so between 90. So let's call 90 the first resistance. 1790 first target in RTY. So RTY target one is 1790. I didn't see that before. If 1791 to 17. Let's see this. 1792, 1791 to 1792. So we're going to call the first target into the 1790. Green veil. We love money. Guys, do you guys love money? Do you guys love money? Love, 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 love money. Okay. You gotta love money in order to trade. It's prerequisite. You love money, money loves you. No, I hate taxes. I think taxes are bullshit. Like, seriously. Like, explain this to me. I go shopping, I pay taxes, and then I have to pay taxes again? Like, what the heck? Yeah, Rick. Yeah, they're the same. Hey, Michael, welcome back. Oh, really, Dan? They're good in taxes? That's cool. I didn't know that. I'm a Florida resident, so I'm happy with the taxes. On the tax thing, I'm happy with it. Okay. So let's see if we get a continuation. By the way, guys, how many of you guys are in YM? I didn't call YM, but some of you guys may be in YM because I did mention this morning that YM may be going higher. So if you guys are in YM, okay. YM is the first one that has achieved a resistance zone here. We still have a lot of room above. You can see here that we're in overbought territory in RTY and we're in overbought territory in YM as well as S&P. All right, so for those of you that are in the Dow, okay, so I'm looking at the clock. I think we should go by the five. All right, so here's what I suggest. If you guys don't want to give any money back, a trail, and you could be out at 835. If it goes below 835, you should be out. Okay, 835, you should be out. Looking here at Russell, and I'm looking at a trail stop of 77. Market may be changing. Trail Russell, RTY 77, we have already achieved target one. Russell Trail 77. And as far as NASDAQ goes, NASDAQ danger zone is 60. 60, NASDAQ trail 60, NASDAQ trail 60. 860, don't let it go below 860. Done, we're done. First portion done. All right. Okay, cool, cool, cool. So in NASDAQ, we had our first target at 880, where we made 40 points. Last half of the trade, we made 20 points. Okay, we made 20 points. You guys can see we're not messing around with ticks here. Okay, we made 20 points. All right, if you trail the whole thing, if you trail the whole thing at 60, you just made 20 points, which is still a lot of dineros, okay? All right. If you took partial profits, you took half out for 40 points, then you took 60. Or then you took, I'm sorry, then you took, you trailed at 60, so you made 20 points. And in RTY, we only made like literally 2 points. 2 points in. Hey, that's money. That's Greenville. All right. That's Greenville. We're going to stock for other trading opportunities. I told you guys and I warned you, it's 10 o'clock. They don't mess around with 10 o'clock. Okay. They don't mess around with the 10 o'clock. All right. If you still want to stay in, Alex, if you still have conviction that the price is going to go higher, and if you have not trailed out of the trade, you could put your stop, for example, at break even, okay, and stay in the trade so you don't lose anything. If you have a conviction on a higher time frame, you could still stay in. Just make sure that you place your stop at a break even. And period, that's it. We should be holding really well this 10 EMA. And in fact, if we break above, I'm looking at some sandwiches here, even at the Dow. The market is, guys, the market is into overbought territory. But that doesn't give us the right to short yet because we don't have any short signals. Okay, we don't have short signals. You can see that every single time the market is pulling back, for example, here in the Dow, the market, the price action is leaving a shadow. These bottoming tails show us that the bears dominated the domain all the way to this low, for example, in the Dow, into the 808. But quickly, the bulls came in and swept away the price and pushed it higher. Therefore, it closed higher than the low. So we had the low and it closed higher than the low. So in this case, 880, if the price gets over 880 in the Dow, we're going to have another leg higher in an attempt on going towards 35,000. And in this case, you can see the 10 EMA alignment. What this means is that the price action is literally holding that power trend intact. This is an ultra power trend. Sometimes it's really hard to trade these ultra power trends because you don't know when they're ending. Okay? You don't know when the institutions are pulling the rug. They're pulling the pin on it. All right. Yeah, oil here is interesting, Lori. Yeah, oil here is very interesting for another leg higher. It does look like it wants to go to 80. 2 minute breakout here. 70, even 79.50 is acceptable for the entry. And I like the fact that on the 2 minute, we have the higher highs and the higher lows. The 20 SMA is going to be the line in the sand here. You can see how the 20 SMA is a reactionary area. So your stop would be like 79.14 around that zone. Keep in mind, super volatile, trade on your own risk. I'm not going to make an official call. I just talked a little bit about it, but it looks very good. It looks very, very good. All right. All right, let's see what we have. We're having a little pause. Now, I did mention the fact that we have the volume is coming in a little bit. NASDAQ is actually forming like a little setup here on the 1 minute. Okay, see this little high, lower high formation? So if it trades below 850, the stop would be 870. The price action may start coming in, but I'm really not liking the fact that every single time it makes a new leg in, this would be like a counter trend. I like to take it with confirmations on the 15. So this is what I would look for. All right, so we have the doji here. So this would only be like a counter short if it trades under 50, but not now, in about 1 to 2 minutes from now, okay? So there are two scenarios here. This is going to be bearish under 850, but not bearish. It's going to be like a swift pullback probably to around 820. It's not even probably going to be worth the risk to reward. And it's going to be bullish over this high, over 87.50. So over 88, it's going to be bullish. Same with the Dow. Dow bullish over 880. Going to put an alert here. So over 880, this is bullish. And if you're looking on the 15 minute, this is going to be bearish under 800. So under 800, this is going to start pulling back. And it depends on your risk tolerance, you know, whether you want to do counter trend trades. Typically, I like to do these fades around lunch because that's when they work. Okay. These are called fade trades. Lunch fades. All right. And here we go. 15 minutes. S&P 45. So anything that trades 44.99. All right. So I'm going to put some alerts here so you guys can see how it works. So under 44.99 is bearish for a pullback all the way to this pivot or the 10 EMA. And over 45.09, this is bullish. So you can see that we have some sandwiches that are happening here. And with NASDAQ, so I said under 50, so that would be like a 49. That would be below. That would be bearish. And if it takes out this high of 88, that's going to be bullish. Okay, so over 88 is bullish. And with Russell is like a one-day wonder here. So it's just crazy strong. But we're going to the 1 hour. This is leaving a shadow here. So this is probably going to get ready. Let's go to the 30 minute to see if we have some indication. Okay. Yeah. Starting to pull back 5 minutes. You guys see how we exited the trade so we don't lose on the trades. All right. Let's go to the 15 minute as the other indices. So if it goes under 75. Okay. So if it gets under 75. Just below, it's going to be bearish with the pullback. It has some room to pull back. It may not pull back. It may pull back only 50%, or it may pull back to the 10 EMA. I'm not a lot into these counter. I love to fade lunch fade. So if we would have continued higher for another 2 hours right now, and if this setup was happening around 12, I would have said, yeah, let's go short. Okay. Let's go short. And then if it takes out the 84.5, all right, so this right here, 84.5 or 84.7, whatever it is, just make sure that it's above that too, because the price action needs to confirm, but it's ready to tackle new highs. All right, so that's the bearish, that's the bullish. And now we could put them back on the 5 minute. All right, not the two, but where's the five? Okay, here it is. All right, so you can see that this is incredibly bullish. All right, it just made a new high right now. You guys can see it. All right, so this is very, very bullish on the 5 minute here. So this is gonna be the race to see if they're going to move higher or not. Okay, and we may have some new trades. Dimitri, what platform are we using? You can use any platform. I'm using Thinkorswim, but you can use any platform. If you're trading micros, for example, I truly suggest you stick with a platform like Ninja or TradeStation that has the better commission rates. Thinkorswim is great if you're using full size contracts because it's a little bit more on the expensive side. All right, so while I'm already triggered higher, and I'm like ready to take some action here. Yeah, John, you can do it, but it's not going to work. Have you tried it? And did you have any success, John, with that? I always call them like every 6 months. Because the more you trade, the more they can negotiate the commissions with you. So I'm not going to have the same commissions with John probably or with anybody else because it depends on you've had some luck. Okay, so here's your great insight. Call, if you're trading on TD Ameritrade, call them to match the commissions. Yeah, Ishan, it's based on volume, how much you trade. I trade a lot of stocks and margin rates. Yeah. And margin rates. Yes. What I do is I call them every 6 months to kind of like tell them, hey, can you take a look at my, and sometimes they give me the Yeah, but we did it last time, and there's like we you didn't trade any different than what you did last 6 months. So sometimes, they can't get to zero, obviously. Exactly. John has a great idea. Do a little research and see what other brokers are using. And I'm thinking, John, that you may be right, especially now that they're going through this transition to Schwab. They like to keep it a little bit more expensive. Hey, you know what? Thinkorswim is a really robust platform. I have to tell you this. It's a really robust platform. It's a really great platform. All right, so we're basing. Now, the next reactionary time in the market is 10:30. So typically when the price action starts to pull back, and if we're getting a pullback from 10 o'clock, usually the price action settles between, let's say, 10:20 and 10:40 latest. And this is going to be the last window of opportunity where I take trades. I love the charts. And here's the scoop, guys. If you guys, and Daniel is using TradeRocket for minis. Perfect. Perfect. I had the opportunity to look at a TradeRocket platform, and I like it. But here's the thing. If you guys like the Thinkorswim platform, you can trade off, and you can have the charting off Thinkorswim. You only can, just deposit some money into it, like $500 or something, and open an account with Thinkorswim. And then you could have access to real-time data, because otherwise it could be delayed. So, okay, here's some, okay, Russell is exploding, for Joe. And I don't know. I'm debating here whether S&P, Nasdaq is not moving, but S&P over 4509 is bullish. John, you're also an RTY. Good job. I think it's a little better, TradeRocket. I like it a little better than NinjaRay. I found it a little easier. I found Ninja to be a little bit complicated for me. But hey, you know what? I literally, I've been with so many platforms throughout the years. I remember, guys, I remember when I was paying $400 just to have a platform. I was paying $400 to have a platform. Do you guys know how expensive trading was when I started trading? Oh my gosh. Everybody that is starting trading right now should be like making money like left and right. When I started trading, I was paying $400 just to have a platform. It was Realtek. Daniel, you got it. You got it. You got it. Exactly. Okay. Admin. All right. $500 just to have a platform. And we're not talking that far away, Chris. We're talking about 2003, 2000 and I'm sorry. 2003, 2004, 2005. So here were my expenses. I had $500 or $400 for a platform. It was Realtek. I think it was 500. It was not 400. It was $500 per month just to have a platform. Just to have a platform. To have access to data, $500 a month. Then I was paying, how much was the room? Was it $600? $500. So it was $500 to be, when I started trading, I was in a trading room just like you guys. So I was paying $500 a month for the trading room, and I was paying $500 a month for the platform. And commissions were so expensive. $10 in, $10 out. $10 in, $10 out. So before I even started trading, I was in a hole of $1,000 every single month. So imagine starting to trade and you're in the hole of $1,000. Yeah, it's true. But what this created, it created the urge to learn how to trade. Now everybody's opening an account. Think about all the Robin Hoods and everything else. Everybody's opening an account and boom, 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 boom. They have no idea how it was, you know, to pay $1,000 at the beginning of the month. And you were like, okay, I start with $1,000 in the hole every single, and it was, you know, a fight to make that $1,000 back just to break even. That's right, Don. Yeah. Really, Nate? Robinhood account, $1,000. And they're still losing money. I don't get Robinhood. Why are they losing money? They have millions of traders. I don't know why they're losing money. All right. So let's focus on one last trade over here because we're getting close to 10:30. So let's put this on the 15 minute. We're still holding. We still have a doji. This is a huge indecision here in NASDAQ. Huge indecision in NASDAQ. Dinged a little bit lower, but is still looking for that peak here. Oh my gosh, Lori, thank you, thank you, thank you. Yeah, because even Lori and Dawn and every, you know, there are a lot of traders in this room that Daniel, that, you know, we started trading a really long time ago and we know how difficult it was. I mean, think about it. It was crazy. Okay. And that forced us to be good. All right, so I still like NASDAQ and S&P. So I'm gonna put two options out here. S&P can be a long over 45.10 with a stop under 45. So just give at least 1 point under 45. Okay, here it is, triggered. And NASDAQ as well, NASDAQ is a long over 888 is the entry. 888 is the entry. And the stop, I would like still to use this low right here, 840 for the stop. Okay. All right. And Joe, oh my gosh, awesome, awesome, awesome. Let's talk about targets. The S&P literally has room to go into the 45.20. That's a huge resistance. So S&P target 45.20. And we have NASDAQ. Well, NASDAQ, of course, we're looking at that 900. NASDAQ target still 900. And that 9, what was it? 917. Let me look at it again. Yeah, 917 to 920. We need to get above that. That's a huge pivot right there. That's a huge, huge pivot right there. All right, these are going to be the last trades. Congrats for those of you guys that are veterans here and that you help through this chop chop. I don't always have a tolerance to live through the chop chop. So that's why I trail. There's always another opportunity to get back in. All right. And the S&P stop is under 4,500. Just give it a 1 or 2 points below that 4,500. So the entry is 45.10, once again, an S&P. 45.10 for the entry, 4,500, just under 4,500 for the stop. Never place your stops at whole numbers. Those are key psychological levels, and they like to punch the price right into that, especially algos, okay? All right, so in NASDAQ, once again, the entry is 888, 15888, and we have the stop at 840, 15840, okay? And we're looking at targets in NASDAQ because when we were in the trade, we trailed and we didn't get to accomplish the 900. Then we have the 15,097. It's 917 to 920. And if we get above that, we could go to 15,950 if we go there today. The overall target is going to be 16,000. And I think they may be on their mission to go towards that area. 16,000 for NASDAQ target, 16,000 overall target. But we'll see if we could just stay in. All right, so NASDAQ order filled. Swell. All right. Now we have to look for synchronicity and for the momentum to continue. Okay, let's take these alerts out. All right. And let's see the extensions. Alex, you mean you... Alex, you paid $25 now? This is free. You got 3 days for free. All right, so you can come in on Friday. Okay. Okie dokie, guys. We are having like a really slow momentum to the upside, like slow, and I mean like boring slow. Volume is constant. Like I said, lower, but constant. I mean, it's not dropping that much. Yeah, I think so. Here's what I'm afraid of. Here's what I'm afraid of. Like, we have had a tremendous rally, 2.2% up in NASDAQ. This is huge. 1.5% in the Dow. I mean, think about the points. We're 500 points up in the Dow, 340 points up in NASDAQ. At any point in time, when you're trading into overbought zones, they can pull the rug. Like, seriously, they can pull the rug big. So we got to trade very cautiously. Okay, very cautious. It's not as much as the R when you're trading, when you're doing these trend, ultra bullish power trends. It's about how much can you, how long can you stay in these trades? Yeah, Randy, there are standard pivot points. Hey, Rao. All right, we're 5 points into the 900. Russell is screaming higher. And we are doing good. We're doing good. We're doing good so far. Okay, 900 is our target one. in NASDAQ, and 4520 is our target one in S&P. Already 5 points up in S&P. S&P a mover. You nailed it, Joe. Yeah, Oliver, I see oil higher and definitely higher. I don't have the heart for it. Like, it's too choppy. I mean, it's trending, but you need to have the tolerance for it. I'm for instant gratification. Boom, boom. Oh my gosh, Joe's a rock star. There you go, John. Awesome. Thank you. Oh, by the way, guys, John has a great point here. You don't have to trade, for example, only NASDAQ. You trade the setups for NASDAQ, but you could trade the Qs, right? So let me put a chart of the Qs here. You can trade the Qs, right? So for example, let's put 5 minute, right? All right, you can see it, same patterns. Exactly, or QLD or TQQQ, if you want the leverage. All right, awesome. Ray, you made $300 monthly cost nearly every trading day. Awesome, Ray. Thank you. All right, so we're back into the 80s in NASDAQ. See, this is the problem because I don't know when they're going to pull the plug here. Let's pay attention to the 15 minutes as well. So this is kind of like where we have our stop. We have our stop at 40, just below this candle, because we want to see if the momentum continues. And at 10:45, we could see if we hold these momentum. Nice base here in gold as well. Notice how the price action is still holding above the 10 exponential moving average. Brand new high for Russell. Nice. New high for NASDAQ. NASDAQ almost one tick away from 900. And by the way, I'm really greedy on targets. I like to see like the target, boom, 900 hit. Although this is the target zone, so you should be aware of the target zone by one tick. We need to get it into that 900 is also a psychological level. Wow, are we ever extended in the market? OMG. We're super extended in the market. All right, new high there in RTY. Just an idea for smaller accounts. Let's see how we close here in S&P. Let me just take a look at something else in S&P because I was thinking to bring the stop to break even in S&P, but yeah, that would be, so 11 is a mini level on the trend. Yeah, let's place the stop in S&P at break even. We're not getting much action, and I'm afraid that they may pull the rug here. So S&P stop at break even. See, if we hold that, we have a mini level at 11 that should hold. And if that level of 11 is not holding, then we want to make sure that we don't lose anything on the trade. So 10, we got it into break even. All right. So I'm going to also put an alert right here. So you can see that it's under this candle low. want to make sure that the weekly sandwich is fire. All right, brand new high, by the way, guys, in YM. Very nice, brand new high. You guys see where we have our trail stop here. A little flaky with NASDAQ, but NASDAQ needs to get over this 900. Do you guys see? So you could trade the Qs or you could trade NASDAQ, whatever you guys want, okay? I like to trade the futures, but you could trade the Qs as well. Super cool. Oh, Michael, market overextended. I use the William percent R. It is mostly a swing trading indicator, but I use it for day trading as well. Let me show you how I use it. All right. So this is the William percent R right here. This indicator, you guys could see my little cursor here. Let me just get it. Okay. So here it is. This is the William percent R. So you see this curve right here that goes up and down, there are two levels of interest in this indicator. There's a minus 80 and the minus 20. When the price action is getting towards the minus 80, the market is getting into an oversold zone, or even below the minus 80, the market is into a way oversold zone. In fact, you could see it here on Monday, right? So it was into an oversold. And once it crosses this 80, minus 80, then the price action starts to move higher. And you could see here how the price action moves higher. And then when it pulls back, you could see this pullback is higher than the prior low. So it's just like in the technical patterns, when you have a higher low, it indicates that the price action may go higher. So that's one of the reasons why we were bullish in yesterday's session as well. We made money to the long side. And then sideways, you can see sideways here, pull back a little bit. So it was getting oversold, and now it's really above the overbought. So it's way above the minus 20. So you can see the indicator is showing overbought activity. Does that make sense, Michael? So it's into an overbought zone. Okay, of course. All right, what are we doing with this Nazi? It's just coiling into the break-even area. When it's in the middle, you're going to see when it's in the middle between that minus 80 and minus 20, you're going to see a continuation of the trend. And when it reaches the upper part of that area, so when it rises, when it's topping, when the indicator is topping, it means that the market conditions are overbought. And when they're in the bottom, oversold. Hey, Graham, no clue. Why would they close trade on you? You got to talk to your broker. Graham, talk to your broker. It's not normal. That does not mean that you're shorting the market. That does not mean that you're going to be shorting the market, because the market can stay in overbought conditions for a relatively long period of time. You need to see the patterns that are going to prove to you that the market is ready for a pullback, for example, for a fade. So if these markets are going to stay into the highs, for example, into lunch on any kind of 30-minute rotation to the downside, that could be a lunch fade. Now, keep in mind, in strong trending markets and very strong trending markets, when you're doing counter trend trades, you're going to go for very small profits. And typically, when you're doing counter trend trades, the first trade is going to fail. So it's always great and a great idea to use half the size, half of your risk. Does that make sense? Because if you're using your whole entire risk, so for example, you're taking the trade with 1 hour, right? You're taking the trade with 1 hour. So what that happens is that you're going to stop out, right? So you're risking your whole risk amount. But if you're risking half, just because you know that these trades, especially counter trades, you're going for a small profit. Sometimes they can deliver a huge profit, okay? But most of the time, you know, they fleece you out the first time around and then they start working. Typically, you need to give them 3 tries. That's why I suggest using half of the size, because they're more likely to stop you out of the trade. Does that make sense? Okay. All right. So we have our target one finally hit in NASDAQ. So this makes me like super, uber happy. We are 3 points away from the high from the 4520, which is target number one in S&P. And that makes us super happy. Okay. Still, we cannot trail that rascal, Nazi. We can't trail it. We can't put a trail on it because we still have support into the 75. So it needs to extend at least into the 917 to 920 before we move our stop. Unfortunately. All right. Looking good. Looking good. So far, I feel very comfortable with S&P because I have my stop and break even. So at this point in time, I have zero risk. So I am literally playing with zero risk, right? I don't have any invested risk. I started with a risk, but now I'm playing with zero risk. And I would like to achieve that goal in NASDAQ, but I can't. I can't put the stop at a break even just yet. It's just 10 points below this, where the price is at right now. All right, cool, cool, cool. Let's hold on to these highs and let's just make new highs. You guys can see that all four indices are making new highs at this point. Oil is punching higher as well from that 2 minute breakout. Yeah, I mean, Joe, what I suggest, do the five minute walk. Five minute. That's what I would do. Oh, absolutely, Doug. Santa rally, and we're gonna do a webinar on that. We're gonna do a webinar very soon, very, very soon. I don't know, maybe we're gonna do it next week because it's just ahead of Thanksgiving, and we're gonna have probably another holiday trading opportunity, so we may have that webinar. How to trade like a hedge fund through the holidays. That includes Santa rally, window dressing. Fun, fun, fun. January effect, cornucopia trading, which is next week. I love trading the markets. Oh my gosh, it's like the best thing ever. Like, seriously, do you guys see yourself retiring from the market? It brings me so much joy. And once you learn how to trade, it's like, oh my God, I gotta take a look at the market. I don't care if you're 20 years old or 99 years old. It's just beautiful. All right. So, what are we doing, guys, with this Nasdaq? My goodness, it's just coiling into our break-even level. Not loving it. Brent, even when you're losing, the most important thing is, to position size and allocate that one bullet, your one R. A lot of traders don't understand that even if you have the crappiest strategy, you could still make money in the market by respecting your position size. Because if you lose your one R, it's so easy to recuperate that R. It's really easy to recuperate the R. But if you have various sizes through your account, so for example, one time you're using a 5-point stop in ES, sometimes you're using a 10-point stop in ES, sometimes you're using a 3-point stop in ES, sometimes a 20-point stop in ES, depending on what time frame you're trading on or the parameters of the trade. So your results are going to vary. And it's going to be, for example, if you have a stop out, let's say of 60 points, let's say in NASDAQ that we had, if you don't position size, that's going to hurt. Okay. Because you're going to lose 60 points. And the next time, if you're going to have a, let's say a 20 point stop, right? That's not going to hurt as much. But if you're just using the R, yeah, it's no big deal. It's an R. And an R loss in the notion of trades is zero. It's nothing. All right. So what do we have here? Slow down in momentum, big time slow down in momentum. Obviously, we're into overbought conditions and we're still flying higher. And say. Let it play out. We can't change the stop. We can't move the stop in NASDAQ. That's for sure. In S&P, if you guys want to exit at 14, acceptable. I'm going to keep my break-even stop. If you want to follow me, my stop is break-even. But if you want to take your money here at 14, you're locking at 14 or 15. You could put an order at 15, and when it spikes to 15, you're out. Let's go back here to watch the momentum on the one. See, it's back to 15. I'm really tempted to take this 15. Yeah, take 15 and out. Have your order at 15 out. We're out right now. 15 out. 5-point gain. 5-point gain. We're out in S&P. Okay. Okay. And we just got to see what we're going to be doing with this NASDAQ. Our entry is 88. It's just coiling around that zone. I'm not loving it that much. See, the 15 minute is reversing here. I don't want to keep the original stop. See, if it gets over 90, it has a chance of going higher on a momentum shift, but we're approaching 11 o'clock and 11 o'clock is just not good for the market. Everything is pulling back. Joe, I would trail 91 and Russell. Everybody that is in Russell, I would trail 91 just into this 10 EMA. Yeah. So we're done with S&P. The only trade that we're in is NASDAQ that is trying to, it's hiccuping here. Very stable YM, by the way. Very stable YM. Let me adjust the charts here. Okay. So I'm keeping this on the 2 minute. Our stop is 840 in this one. So ultimately what I'm going to try to do here, let's see if we could do a damage control to show you how we could do a damage control here. So we have the stop, the original stop at 840. We want to see if we get a smaller time frame. Yeah, no, it's just triggering that 15 minute. Yuck. All right. We just need a quick momentum backup. Keep the original stop in NASDAQ. We don't have a choice. See, NASDAQ was the one that was kind of signaling some issues here. We have target one that was achieved, but the rest, we got to keep the original stop. We don't have a choice. We have a 2 minute. Wow, Dowski with a new high here. Let's see if we could save this trade. This would be a 5 minute buy, but it's not gonna do much for us because we already have an entry at 88, so we need to get it back to 88. We don't have a choice. Come on, you can do a Nasdaq, get back into the 88. See, this is not going to help much because the trigger would be 86 to 87 and we have an 88, so it's not going to help us average out in this situation. It's 11 o'clock. We have a new high, like I said, in YM, just punched in 4 minutes ago, and we're getting ready for a 5 minute, again, punch higher back over 15. This 15 has been a big line in the sand for the S&P, and we're still holding above the 10 EMA on the 2 minute in RTY, and on the 5 minute, we're getting ready for a sandwich. So if Russell is going to get over 94.4, it's really going to go higher. So this may create a little bit more bullishness for NASDAQ here. Semiconductors are ripping higher. We have Microsoft with a brand new high, Amazon higher, Apple higher, Nvidia higher, Meta is pulling back, Google is pulling back, but we have Costco strong, we have Cisco, Adobe higher, yet pulling back right now. We have Comcast that is very strong, Intel that is about to break. For those of you guys that are looking for a swing trade, Intel on the daily chart, if over $39.20, it will start moving higher. Qualcomm gapped up with the high, maintaining the highs. AMD is crushing it to the upside. Micron crushing it to the upside. PayPal, even some of the weakest stocks are moving higher. Starbucks with a beautiful breakout as well. Netflix, another leg higher. So I don't know what the rain delays here for NASDAQ for not making new highs here, or at least to trigger this 15-minute rotation. So in about 2 minutes, this 5-minute candle is going to close. So that's going to speak volume for us, because if we manage to get it above 80, it's going to show us that the price may be ready to move higher. But at the same time, keep in mind, the price action is in between the 20 and the 10, which I don't like. I don't like when the price is caught in between moving averages. Not fun. All right, we need to wait a few more seconds until we close this candle. Dow incredibly strong. And this is an example of how difficult it is to trade a power trend, because you don't know at what point in time they're going to be pulling the rug. That's why we have to be super, super careful. And that's why we took just 5-point profit in S&P. I mean, for a lot of people, 5 points to make those 5 points is like fantastic, right? Because yeah, it's 5 points. But for us, we are looking for velocity. We're looking for continuation. But today, even though we're green, continuation is really hard. Okay, so this is the line in the sand, guys. If the price action gets over 78 to 79, This is gonna be at 78.5. Price action is gonna start moving higher. It needs this level in order to start moving back into 96 to 98. A power trend is formed by higher highs and higher lows, and especially if a smaller time frames are above the 10 exponential moving average, that shows an ultra power trend, just like we have in the Dow right here. Okay, verbal? All right, just like we have here. This is a definition of a power trend, higher highs, higher lows, grinding higher. The price needs to stay above the 10 exponential moving average. Come on, Nancy, you can do it. You can do it. All right, so how do you guys like the trading room? How do you guys like the trading room? No pressure, everything's relaxed, everything is calculated in advance, everything is just, you know, with limit orders, we're not jumping in, we're calculated, we have time to position size, we have time to analyze charts, we have time for everything. Hey, April, nice to see you. All right. So we need to get this NASDAQ. Oh, if you want to visit more and learn more about the trading room, thanks so much. You could check out the link at tradelaw.com/services futures trading room. We have the link right there. You could just click on it. Hi, Lise. Awesome. Okay, cool, cool, cool stuff. And typically we don't take so many trades that we took today. We don't. Okay. So this is a critical level right here that I'm looking at. So the 15 minute, if it takes out this 59, it's gonna pull back. So I'm thinking we should really tighten the stop in this. You can see that the momentum is fading out. We're getting very close to lunch. And after, when we wrap up the session today, I will talk about some potential fades in the afternoon. Like I said, after 12 o'clock. So or beginning with 12 o'clock. I think it's too early for fades. You can see that the power, the money, the institutional power pressure is still invested in, and they're taking the price higher. And YM is on a mission to get into that 35,000, where I'm going to think I'm going to take my money and run. The swing that we took, November 7th. And I got in at 34,165. 34,165. All right, market is stalling right now. All right, I want my 5 minute trigger in NASDAQ. And if I have my 5 minute trigger in NASDAQ, I'm gonna put the stop just below 860. So we're gonna move it higher than where it is right now. We have our stop at 840. And if the price gets over 880 again, we're gonna move it to 860. So reducing our risk to 28 points. It just needs to close above this 10 EMA and tackle this high. Ugh, come on, you can do it. It's 11:10. You didn't do it now. I think we should move it anyway. All right, let's NASDAQ move stop from where we had it at 840 to 860. So we're moving at 20 points higher. Which is cool. Because we've already hit target one at 15,900. YM is attempting to make a new high. And I think it's seconds away from making a new high. You guys could see it here. 836 is the high for today. And we just made this high a second ago. 9:36. So 9:36, we need to break over it. Russell, wow, brand new high. S&P, brand new high. So you have to have, you know, the tolerance for these kind of stomach for the type of trades today. And I don't want anybody to lose anything here. So that's why I'm super, super careful. Rick, do you take swing trades on a different account than the day trading? Yes, I do have two separate trading accounts. And guys, it's 11:11, make a wish. Okay, can everybody wish that NASDAQ goes to 16,000? Like right now. Yes, I do use two separate accounts because I don't want to have my day trader hat on when I look at the market. Come on, you could do it. You could do it. So we have reduced the stop in NASDAQ to 860, and we're closing in on break even at our original entry, 888. We couldn't, and I was tempted like here to add at 78, but it wouldn't do much for us. Like if we would have pulled back, for example, to 840, let's say, and if we would have like not even to 840 where we had our stop at a little bit higher, like 841. And if we would have rotated and find a different entry at 850 or 856, yeah, that would make sense because it would give us a much better average for our price. Okay. Can anybody say we're at break even? My wish, $1 million. Joe, if it's a wish, why not wish for a billion? Like only 1 million, that's not enough. You live in California. Add some zeros. Like seriously. Okay, we're at break even right now. Okay, so you guys see how we're analyzing. Technically, we're not taking crazy decisions. Everything that we talk about and I talk about and all the decisions that I take, they're solely based on charts, candles, patterns, trends. Me too, Rick. It's like, can I have like, what do you mean? Can I put like more wishes? And at New Year's or when it's my birthday, I always wish, like I make like this wish that basically is made out of like a gazillion wishes. It's like only one. Are you kidding me? Like we're going for it. Like at New Year's, I go like, oh, gotta do this and do that. And I'm very superstitious with New Year's. You always have to have cash. So you got to stuff it in your pocket or you hold it in your hand at New Year's. So remember, New Year's this year, have your cash, okay? Hold on to your cash. You're going to have a lot of money all year. No, seriously. I'm like religious about this. You got to have the cash. Hold it in. I typically like to hold it in my hand, right? So I hold $100 in my hand. So I fold it and I hold it and I'm like, yes. So when the new year starts, you already have cash in your hand. Yeah. And don't buy anything on the first. Okay. Just don't buy anything. Okay. We're getting here into new highs. I'm going to go on a quick 1 minute here. I was debating to close the trade at break even right here. Yeah, let's close it. Let's do this. Hold on. Yeah, let's close the trade at break even. Break even 88. We fought enough. 88. Done. At 88, we're done. Put your stops at 88. If you took it out, you took it out. I have my stop at 88 right now. I am not negotiating. If the price goes down to 88 right now, I'm out. It's at 89. Now it's at 90. 89 still. Have my stop at 88. And I'm out. Out, out, out. Out at break even. Here's the problem that we're having right now. And I'm going to share this with you. You can write it down. This is a good tip to have. There are certain momentum times into the market. First momentum is between 9:30 and 9:32 when the market opens. Then the second momentum is at 9:45. The third momentum is at 10 o'clock. And the last momentum is at 10:30. Okay. So notice that the momentums from 9:30 to 10 o'clock. So basically from 9:30 to 10 o'clock, you got the 9:32, you got the 9:35, you got the 9:45, and you got the 10 o'clock, right? So from 9:30 to 10 o'clock, you got four momentum. So you have four opportunities to get in trades if the price action is cooperating, if the price action is moving for you. Now notice that from 10 o'clock to 10:30, there are no momentums, because if you have a strong momentum like we've had today, and we're going to talk about this as well, you had a strong momentum like you had today, typically at 10 o'clock, the price action is going to start digesting, or it's going to start pulling back. If you're having a base into the highs, okay, if you're having a base into the highs, it means that the price action may be ready to go higher. But if it's not going higher right after 10:30, between 10:30 and I would say 11:15, you need to be out, because that means that there's going to be a shift of momentum into the market, and the market is likely going to pull back, or it's stalling into the highs and then be getting ready for that lunch fade. Okay, does that make sense, everybody? Does that make sense? Okay. All right. We're gonna go through the market in just a second. Right. All right. I do scalp sometimes, but the reality is that I don't want to scalp because I want to get more money. So if I look at the market, I'm looking for velocity trades. Okay. So I'm looking for trades that can deliver more and not be in front of the computer, go like, oh, click, 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 click. You know what I mean? Like, I just want to trade relaxed. I chat a lot in the trading room. Everybody that is in here knows that we talk everything under the sun about trading. Okay. So yeah. All right. So I do like to scalp, but I think you have to have like that scalping market I would rather make the big bucks in the market than scalp the market. So that is my approach to trading. Okay, so Vita has a good question. So institutional trading is done. Typically, institutional trading is done around 11 to 11:15, okay? And then at 11:30, we have the doldrums that are stepping in. Price action becomes a lot whippier. You should compact your charts to a higher time frame, 15 minute, 30 minute, because if you take trading decisions based on the 1 minute, 2 minute, 5 minute around lunchtime from 11:30 to around 2 o'clock, you're going to find out that you're going to stop out a lot. Okay. You're going to stop out a lot. All right. So hold on just 1 second. We're going to go through the market and we're going to do the quick wrap. Okay. All righty. All right. So I'm going to send you my stats. Okay. With the trades. Okay. My stats with the trades from today to see how much money I made. All right, we're all green. What a successful day. What a great day. All right, so first off, let's talk about the markets, right? We want to talk about the markets. And we want to talk of what happened. There was a question here in the trading room about what made the market move up today. Now, before you even take any trades, you need to know what is likely to impact the market every single day. Because you can get in a trade and then you can have some high impact news that is coming in and it's just going to mess your day up because it's just going to run you over because you have no idea what to expect. This morning at 8:30, we have the core CPI numbers and we had the CPIs. And basically, these are high impact releases that are happening into the market, and they create a huge move into the market, If the move is with the trend, then that move becomes so much more powerful than it would be against the trend. So watch that on your next momentum move. Now, tomorrow we have the core PPI numbers, we have core retail sales, we have Empire State Manufacturing Index, and we have the PPI numbers and the retail sales that are coming at 8:30. So we have five data that we're expecting at 8:30. So that means that the price action is going to go ballistic tomorrow. We cannot forecast how the market will react. But what we can be in control in is how we prepare for the day. I typically don't trade ahead of releases. I trade the effects of the releases because I like to trade not based on, you know, guesses, because everything is an unknown. Plus, tomorrow we still have some earnings. So these two things are impacting every single day market. So we have, number one, we have economic releases. And we have, and of course, in the pre-market game plan today, we went over the pre-market releases. So those are impacting the market. Plus, we have earnings. We still have a few more weeks of earnings. Now, in December, earnings are going to fade out. And you're going to notice that in December, trading is going to be a lot harder than what it is right now because earnings season is winding down. You're going to have very few companies that are remaining to report. You're not going to have any power players. Plus, towards the end of the year, you're also going to have a lot less economic releases. Plus, you have a lot of things that are creating divergency in the market, such as option quadruple witching option expiration, which is in December. You have the contract roll in December because we're futures traders. And those are going to create some strong, choppy currents. Okay? Strong, choppy currents. We're going to notice that at the end of each quarter, whether it's March, June, whether it's September or December, trading those particular months becomes extremely difficult. Now, just to highlight, Doja Man reminded me yesterday that option expiration is this week. So option expiration is this Friday. So that means that, keep in mind, because we already had some things happening today into the market. Typically on an option expiration week, you're going to experience three things every single time. A big up move, a big down move, and then a huge range formation, and not in that particular order. Now, here's the deal. Today, we had our big up move. Tomorrow, we have data. We have to see if we maintain the big up move with another big up move, or we're going to get our big down move. So we're going to be on our toes going into tomorrow's trading. Okay. So like I said, for the Dow, before we continue with anything else, for the Dow and into our analysis, for the Dow, my target is 35,000. Okay. And as soon as it, and if it's going to get above 35,000, I'm going to start looking at 35,000 as a trail because I had like a phenomenal run into YM, into my swing from last week. So that's the end discussion with that swing trade. All right. And that's because we have it open and a lot of you guys are still in. Now, today the market had a big splash to the upside. The splash to the upside, and let me just shrink these charts so we can have a better gauge of price action. I like to zoom in a little bit more when we're trading because I pay attention at candlestick formations, the information that these candlesticks are offering in relation to the indicators where they're at and the patterns that they form. So number one, what do we have today? We had the numbers that came out today. We have the core CPI and the CPI numbers that came out. And we saw a big surge of momentum higher in all of the indices. I mean, I thought literally that was a typo in RTY. I couldn't believe my eyes. I was like, wow, is this real? Because RTY is 5% up. This is huge. 5% up. Are you kidding me? 86 points in RTY. This is incredible. So, and by the way, remember our ultimate target in Russell was 1800 and I said it has room to run to 1800. We're almost there by three ticks. Now, before I move to the analysis, I just want to reiterate that trading power trends is very difficult. In fact, it's one of the most difficult things. Trading trends is awesome because you have the pullbacks, you have 1-2-3 bar pullbacks, or you have 1-2-3-4 bar pullbacks, and then you have another rotation. When you're getting these power trends, and if you can see these charts, you don't have pullbacks. So if you're not in a trade and if you're not trained to identify tight opportunities, you cannot get in. Chasing is not an option because if you start getting into a trade, okay, if you start getting into a trade, you have no idea when they're going to pull the rug because you need to know the momentums that are happening into the market and you need to be aware of the resistance areas and the reaction into the resistance areas because sometimes they can just crush it to the upside and they could just move to another, to a different level. So from level to level higher, or if they're pulling back, they're pulling back, okay? All right. So what do we have today? We have the big CPI numbers and we have the power trend. Very difficult, as you guys could see, very difficult to get in to these trades. Yet we had some beautiful entries, right? All in all today, we had four trades. We had two trades in NASDAQ, one trade where we generated some really nice momentum to the upside, one that hit target one, and then we trailed the rest at break even. We had S&P, we didn't have any losses. S&P moved for 5 points for us, and we trailed it at, we had our entry at 45.10, and we got out at 45.15, and we had Russell. Russell was a tough one for me because I didn't want you guys to lose on anything, so we just took two points out of it. So from 75 to 77, yet you see it here, look. But look at the grind. I mean, hindsight, you know, this is the pullback that spooked us, right? And then it continued higher, okay? You don't know when they're pulling the rung. And plus here, we were into resistance. Okay, so now let's see what we have for the afternoon session. Afternoon session should be observed only on a 30-minute basis or a one-hour basis. I'm going to put to the 30-minute basis because we are and again, we're trading, like I said before, we're trading an overbought condition. All right. So here is the 30 minute here. All right. So first of all, notice where the price is at and notice where our indicator is at, the 10 EMA, the 20 SMA, the 50 SMA. By the way, for those of you guys that don't know what indicators I'm using, I'm using the 10 exponential moving average, the 20 simple moving average, the 50 simple moving average, and you can see here the 200 simple moving average. Aside from these moving averages, I use pivot points. These are regular pivot points that are provided by the thinkorswim platform, and I have been using them for more than 20 years. All right, so from this point on, what we can expect from the market? Market is definitely into overbought conditions. The market is very extended from the 10 EMA in all the indices. Notice the S&P, notice the NASDAQ, notice the Russell. Can it have room to move higher? Of course it does. Of course it does. And like I said before, in the pre-market game plan, you can watch the recording of this session here, including the pre-market game plan. And I said, we have room today, or tomorrow, or whenever the price decides to move, but we have room to run into 35,000, and then we have room to run into the 300, and if we top off 300, there's nothing stopping us all the way to 36,000. Now the S&P, right? The S&P has room for higher. 45.20 is where we're trading at right now, and we have room all the way to the 45.50. NASDAQ, onto the daily chart. Here we go. We just crossed above this 720 level and we're trading into frothy resistance into the 900. This is a big deal with the 900 because it has a lot of resistance from July. It has residue resistance from July. So that means that it needs to still take that high out. So what is different in NASDAQ? And what is different in NASDAQ that is literally not affecting the Dow and S&P is the resistance. Is the fact that resistance in S&P is all the way to 45.50 to 45.60. Resistance here is at 35.300. So they still have room to run into this resistance, At the same time, NASDAQ is into resistance. So NASDAQ is reacting and is not advancing because at this moment in time, it cannot take out the 900. It needs to consolidate or it needs to pull back in order to digest that zone, in order to pull to push further higher. Now, let's take a look at Russell compared to the rest of the indices. Russell took out the prior high into this 1780. Took out as well the 95. Remember, we were discussing that 95 level to 1800. And this is the 1800 level, okay? So you can see here that Russell is in many ways similar in price action with NASDAQ, but it's a lot stronger. Look at the percentage gain, 5%. Look at the percentage gain, 2%, okay? So if we break above 1800, in Russell, we could start moving higher towards this 200 SMA right here into the 30, 35, 36. And we have another prior pivot high into the 24. So if we break above 1800 today, we have room to 1820 and 1830 to 1835. Okay, does that make sense, guys? That makes sense with you? All right, so this is why NASDAQ is stalling here, because it has this double top formation and it has a lot more resistance than the rest of the indices. That's why YM has more room to run and is developing faster. The S&P has more room to run, developing faster, and same with Russell. Okay, now we're going back to, let's go back to the 1 hour. Okay, let's go back to 1 hour. Now, in about 25 minutes from now, these candles on the 1 hour are going to close. All right, where's the hour? Okay, here it is. All right. So the one thing that I look at is, what kind of formation do we have? I'm not even talking about extension, right? I'm just talking about, you know, how we're moving through. Okay. So, all right. So here we go. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 up from this explosive move from the range breakout. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 up from this explosive move from the range breakout. So basically we have range breakout throughout. What I'm going to be watching for, and if I would be trading the afternoon, would be how we close. And any kind of reaction after 12 o'clock, if we take out this low, I think we're heading for a pullback. And that would be the lunch fade. You would be waiting for the S&P to close for another 25 minutes. And if the price action is going to break the low, wherever that low is going to be, watch out for the pullback. The first index that is showing us signs of topping at 900 is NASDAQ. Here's 903. Our first target was 900. Target achieved. Now, if the price action breaks at this moment in time below 850, and remember, we had already that print of 848. So you need to give it a little bit more room. 3 points, I would say, in this volatility would be okay. So if it takes out the 4745, this is going to start pulling back. Okay, it's going to start pulling back. So the pullback may be back into a psychological level of 800 and then back down into the 10 EMA. These would be the areas where you would look for profit target zones. As long as the momentum is strong, you're going to look for a continuation higher. Okay. So that means that if you're still day trading for the afternoon, you're going to be looking for a continuation on the 5 minute, on the 15 minute. As long as the 1 hour remains intact, you're still going to look for that pressure to the upside. Does that make sense, everybody? Okay. So the fade is after the top of the hour. So after 12 o'clock, you're going to look for the lows, wherever these lows are. Okay. Wherever these lows are, these candles right here, you're going to look for the lows. Your stops are going to be the 1 hour highs. If you don't want to stop out as often, those are going to be your stops. Okay. Along the way, you may have a development of 15 minute tops, and you could actually take it sooner than the 1 hour. Okay. This would be like the first aggressive try, let's say, for a lunch fade. But remember, typically you need to really watch the 1 hour. Okay. Because remember, you're still trading above the 10 EMA. So if you guys know anything about power trends, you know that you don't short above moving averages and you don't short above the 10 EMA. Okay. All right. However, if the price action is hyperextended from the 10 EMA, you can short with the target into the 10 EMA. Okay. Oh my gosh, Lori, can you please post it for everybody? Oh my goodness. April, just go to where you import your indicators and look for pivot points. All right. Okay, guys, so I just want to show you something very quickly. All right, so Here we go. Just one second. Give me one second here. All right, so Michael Burry has closed his short position in Nasdaq and S&P with a loss of 40%. Do you guys think that Michael Burry is smarter than we are? No, he's not. No, he's not. Imagine blowing up 40%. Okay, fun fact. Fun fact. Okay. I would compete with Michael Burry any day. Trading competition. If he wants 1 day trading competition, if he wants a 1 week trading competition, if he wants a 1 year trading competition. I would go all in, and I can guarantee you that I'm going to come ahead big time. Okay, number one, Doji Man, correct. They don't position size. They don't position size. Number two, they never use stop. Okay, never use stops. All right. All right. So what I want to share with you real quick here is, all right, let me just take my share screen. Okay, because we're going to wrap up in 1 second here. Just give me 1 second. What did I click? All right. Okay, guys. All right, we're almost done. And we're happy. Okay. So you guys can see the screen right now? Okay, hold on. Okay, cool. All right. This is our performance portfolio. And okay, this is our performance portfolio for this year, okay? And this is November. These are the last four trades right here that we took today. These are the last four trades that we took today, all right? And these are per one contract, one full-size contract, okay? The results are per one full-size contract. When you decide to join the Trade Outlaw Trading Room, you will have access to this performance portfolio that has a lot of bells and whistles. First of all, you heard me today talk about risk management a lot and position sizing. This is where you're going to find out how many contracts you need to take the trade with. All right, so when you scroll in here, you're gonna see that you have access to your risk calculator. You go boom, boom, you have it right here. You type in the amount of money that you have in your account, the risk per your trade, whether you decide to trade half the percent or maybe 1%. Okay, maybe 1%, 2%. I use 1%, by the way, when I'm day trading. I use 2 to 3% when I'm swing trading. Okay. But all right. So for example, you have a 60-point stop in NASDAQ, right? 60 points. If you're using $5,000 per trade, 60 points, you could with 60-point stop, you could take 4 contracts. What happens if you take, if you have a 500 risk amount? If, let's say you have a $50,000 account, you risk 1%, so that's $500, right? So with $500, if you have a 60-point stop, you could take it with 4 micros, okay? So is that helpful, guys? You get access to this. This is our year to date, all right? This is 2023 right here, Okay. So you can see here our performance. Okay. I didn't put October. So let's see October. I'm going to put it right here. October is right here. 23,075. Okay. So 23,075. This is how much money we've made per contract during the month of October. So already up at $124,000 trading with only one contract right here, 2023. And we still have 2 months to go, right? We still have 2 months to go. Now in 2021, and we have this track record since 2017, by the way, since I began the futures trading room. So in 2021, 161,000, 2022, 175,000. Let's see if we're going to top it this year, if we're going to go for the record. Okay, we still have time and we have window dressing. So I'm looking forward to that. All right, so this is what you're getting access to. You get some rules, guidelines, funding, roll dates, year to date, which I think it's cool. You have all the option expirations, all in one sheet for our members. Platform layout for those of you guys that, you know, want to use TD Ameritrade, Thinkorswim, I should say, Schwab, right? Extra charting, you have holidays throughout the year. I'm very excited about next week. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to have some days off. It's going to be so cool, right? All right. So one other thing that I wanted to show you, this is my performance, okay? So what happens in here when I take a trade, it goes directly into my performance. Okay. So this is January. This is year to date, January 1st through November 14th. Okay. You can see my returns in percentage. I guess Michael Burry would kill himself right now. Okay. These are my my returns. This is my profit and loss ratio, and this is my returns. My account size is $500,000, by the way. That's it. All right. So that's what I have. Rick, my maximum drawdown is $5,000 per trade. That's it. That's the maximum drawdown that I have. My win percentage is 65%. And I can tell you right now that you can have a win ratio of literally 40% and make a killing in the market if you know what you're doing, okay? If you know what you're doing. So I hope you guys had a great time today. I will see you guys tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of the day. We had a phenomenal day. Get ready for tomorrow. Remember, the results are only from less than 2 hours of trading every single day. All right. So thanks so much, everybody. I will see you guys tomorrow in the trading room bright and early at 9 o'clock. Don't be late. See you guys then. Have a good one.